right, let's continue. So far we only dealt with functions of only one variable. So f of x, g of y, so on and so forth. We only had one variables. How do we plot if we have multiple variables? So we have two options. Option one is contour plot. Option two is plot in 3D. Let's start with the contour plot. Contour plot. So let's say this function is, in this case, we have multiple variables. Cosine of x plus cosine of y. Let's say this is the function. And I would like to plot this for the range of x goes from 0 to 4 pi. Close the curly bracket. And then let's say y. This goes from 0 to 4 pi. And we are closing the curly bracket again. And then we have the square bracket. And press right enter. Alright? So as you can see, this is color coded. So, but we don't know what color means what. So if you like to show the color, the legend for the color, we just go back and put another option here. After the last item, after this, the last curly bracket, we are going to say plot legends. So we select this, and then I'm going to select automatic. So there are two options, either expressions or automatic. I press automatic and then replot it. And you can see it is color coded right now. So you can see the bright color indicates this is the highest point. This is the lowest point. So this is a hill here, this point here. The blue point here is a valley, okay? So this is one way. We can also plot the same function, let's say this cosine x plus cosine y function, using plot 3D instead of contour plot. Let's say plot 3D. So I'm not even going to change the options. I'm just going to press enter. You can see here, this is the function. And I can pan around this graph using the mouse here. I can rotate it around. I can select any way I like. And as you can see, we have hills and valleys. So this is perfectly overlapping. I mean, this is, if you compare these two graphs, they are essentially the same information. So just different way to visualize them. And it's just choice which way you like it more. I mean, if you are a more 2D person, this function, this graph is maybe more suitable for you. But if you like to visualize things in 3D, this is more suitable option. So, all right. So this is nice. So now let's see a little more about the contour plot. So let's say if I'm interested in a function that is defined in a region. So I have contour plot. Let me just copy paste it. So instead of having no restriction, I can say I would like to plot a function where cosine x plus cosine y is equal to 1. And let's increase the range a little bit. So in this case, I'm going to get a line, right? So the solution of this equation, cosine x plus cosine y equal to 1, it basically construct a line. It's a curve, actually. So if you look at, if you just press here, let's see, what is this? Let's see here. Right, I have to use equal, so double equal sign here, otherwise it wouldn't work. So at this point, these are the curves that basically corresponds to where cosine x plus cosine y is equal to 1. So these are the ranges where we have x and y. So it is going from, this is about 25. This is about 25. So this the solution of this this equation creates a curve that are basically shown with blue lines, right? So you can also have, you can show multiple lines in here. Let's say if you're interested in multiple equations, so absolute value, for instance, sine x sine y, I close it and I need to use comma. Let's say the first function, let's say this is equal to 0.05. And then I'm putting imposing second condition. Let's say absolute value cosine x multiply by cosine y is equal to 0.5. And I close the squiggly parentheses. So I have to also close this parentheses here. And then I can just press right enter. And this is how it looks like. So these are the curves that describe these equations. The first, the blue one, is going to correspond to this function, where absolute, where the sine x times sine y, the absolute value is equal to 0.5. These are the circles, about circles, for this function. The second one is the orange, shown in orange color. Here the absolute value of cosine x times cosine y is equal to 0.5. And this is these are the solutions for each curves. So as we did in the past, we can also choose a region. We can plot the contour function. For instance, we are interested in plotting, let's say, x square minus y square. I'm interested in plotting this function. Let's say from x goes from -3 to +3. And then likewise, y goes from -3 to +3 again. I'm closing the parentheses. And this is how it looks like. So in this case, I plot without any restriction. And if I would like to restrict x and y to a certain domain, so I will just do as follow, do the following. I'm going to use comma and I'm going to say region function. So it appears already here. So I'm going to say this function, the region function is the function of x, y, and z. And it is defined as follows. 2. So I'm interested in when x squared plus y squared is between 2 and 9. Alright, so I would like to also show the region, so I close this square bracket. And then I would like to have plot legends, and I would like to have them automatic. So let's see if everything is typed correctly. Alright, so what happened here? We have this function, we plot it in a region where x square plus y square is between 2 and 9. So x square plus y square defines a circle. So 2 square root of 2 is the inner radius. And square root of 9 is basically 3. This is the outer radius. So we are plotting this this whole function between inner radius square root of 2 to outer radius 3. This is how we create a domain within a function. And you can do the same thing. You can do the same thing with plot 3D. Plot 3D. Let's say, let's just press OK. And as you can see, this is how it looks like. So it looks like a Pringles, you know, a potato chip with a hole inside, all right? So this is the function x squared minus y squared restricted in this domain. And these two graphs are identical, just different ways to show it. So these two graphs are identical. It's a different way to show the data. All right, let's pause here.